When a General Conference Legislative Committee takes action on a petition that I don't agree with, what can I do as a delegate? Great question. In this video, I will talk about two options that delegates have to change the course of action on legislation that has passed through a legislative committee: minority reports and reconsideration. The ADCA has a simple flowchart to show the legislative process. However, after a legislative committee has acted on legislation, you can change the path that legislation is on. One option is the minority report. If your legislative committee takes action on a petition and you think it should have gone in a different direction, you can get a group of dissenters to submit a minority report. A minority report is not simply disapproval of the petition. It is an alternative proposal of what the legislation should contain. The first step is to notify your legislative committee chairperson about your intent to submit a minority report. You must give notice within 2 hours after the committee's final action on the petition. That way, the committee's action and the minority report can be submitted together for processing the legislation. Once you have written the minority report, you must get signatures from 10 members or 10% of your legislative committee, whichever number is less. All signers must have voted against the legislative proposal. When the relevant petition comes to plenary for consideration, the minority report is treated like a substitute motion. One of the minority report signers can present it, then the motion to substitute the minority report for the legislative item approved by the committee is debated. No amendments can be made during this debate. When debate closes and before a vote is taken, the speaker for the minority report can speak again, followed by the presenter of the legislative committee's report. If the vote for the minority report succeeds, it becomes the main petition, and debate and amendments can continue on it. If it fails, the plenary continues to debate and amend the original petition as presented. Another alternative path for legislation is reconsideration. This option is available to any delegate, not just those who are in the legislation's committee. The committee may place a legislative item on the consent calendar that you want to be debated in plenary, either because you think it should be voted down or because you think it needs amendment before it is approved. In that case, have 20 delegates sign a request and submit it to the Secretary of the General Conference. The deadline is 3 o'clock on the day that the item appears on the consent calendar in the Daily Christian Advocate. Once a petition is lifted from the consent calendar, it cannot be returned to the consent calendar. General Conference is required to take a vote on every petition that has been supported by a legislative committee, which includes items lifted from the consent calendar. However, it is not guaranteed that such petitions will get a full measure of debate. Depending on where the petition is placed on the order of business, and how rushed the plenary is to get through all petitions, the petition could get swept into an omnibus motion for action right before adjournment. Petitions that were not supported in legislative committee may also be reconsidered. This only applies to petitions that were individually voted down. It does not apply to legislation that was rejected in favor of another item dealing with the same paragraph or subject. If you want to have an unsupported petition reconsidered, get 20 delegates to sign a request and submit it to the Secretary of the General Conference by 3 o'clock on the day that the item appears in the DCA. If the petition does come up for debate, one of the signers must be prepared to speak for it, because the legislative committee did not support it. However, there is no requirement that General Conference take action on items that were not supported in legislative committee. Getting the petition presented in plenary for consideration depends on the committee on agenda and calendar deciding where to list it in the order of business, and on the plenary body moving efficiently through all its business before adjourning. In each of these scenarios for redirecting a piece of legislation, timing is very important. For a minority report, notice has to be given within 2 hours of the committee's vote. For reconsideration of legislation either on the consent calendar or not supported, a request has to be submitted by 3 p.m. on the day that the outcome is reported in the DCA. In the press of each day's business during General Conference, it could be easy for those deadlines to slip past you. It helps to work with a group of like-minded people, whether that's your delegation, caucus, or a group of friends. Note down any legislation of concern in your legislative committee, and enlist delegates or observers in other legislative committees to do the same. That way, you can compare notes and be ready to take action. If you can't get reports from every committee, have at least one person in your group check the DCA each morning, reading the lists of legislation reports, and marking ones for reconsideration. Through these measures, you have an opportunity to redirect legislation from the Legislative Committee's recommended path. General Conference processes hundreds of legislative petitions, and much of the heavy work is done by legislative committees. But legislative committees do not have the final say. At previous General Conferences, minority reports have been adopted, and items have been reconsidered to good effect. As a delegate, make use of the processes available to you so that your voice is heard. If you have questions about what I have explained, or suggestions for more topics to cover, leave a comment below. You can also subscribe to get notifications about my future videos. Thanks for watching.